second webinar on out-of-home advertising. It is one of the sectors that has been impacted by COVID-19 the most. However, now that we have learned to live with the virus around us, mobility has started, many offices have opened again, restrictions have eased. So is this now the time again for marketers to reconsider spending on out-of-home? That is what we are trying to discuss today. And also, are media companies ready, you know, for perfect solutions for brands? So the topic today is out-of-home advertising ready to make streets feel alive? We have a very, very esteemed panel with us, and I'm going to go in the alphabetical order. We have Mr. Ajay Mehta, MD Kinetic India. We have Mr. Gautam Hirani, MD iTalk Media Ventures. Mr. Pramod Bhandula, Executive Chairman, JCDCorp. Mrs. Camera has some issues, but he's audible. He's very much with us. Mr. Siddharth Bhutalia, CMO Air Asia. Mr. Upinder Singh, Project Director, Edge One Outdoor Media Management Software. Ms. Vinku Chakravarti, Business Head, Rappo India. Welcome all of you. I think I was reading it too fast. Welcome to each one of you on the panel. I hope we all are audible to each other. And before we start the discussion, I would first open it up with a generic question that now that the lockdown has eased, things are trying to get better. How are you as agencies, Vinku and Ajay can start, either of you, are trying to reach out to clients and agencies again, Vinku, you want to start?
Nazia, first of all, thank you for inviting me to this panel. To answer your question, we have been working on plans and we have been sharing a lot of data with our clients. There's a lot of data nowadays which is available about the consumer. And we have our own bespoke planning tools, basis which we are able to understand the consumer mobility, understand the traffic movements. And we have been sharing these data inputs with the clients. And in some cases, we have also shared plans with them. And a couple of campaigns have even started in the last week of June. So this is how we are in touch with the clients, and internally we are gathering a lot of information across the markets, whether it is tier 1, tier 2, tier 3, so that, you know, we actually get to know the news from ground zero, what's happening, what's changing, because there is so much of dynamism in today's situation that what is right today might not be right tomorrow. So it's imperative at our end to collect the most relevant and the correct information. So with armed with this data and the information, we are reaching out to our clients and discussing with them about future plans.
And what is the kind of response that you're getting?
See, they are also skeptical because they're also getting a lot of news, you know, from all across, from all the channels. And they are getting questions, are getting asked, especially about the metro markets. Because if you look at entire country, I would say metro markets are the most affected. And traditionally speaking, metro markets take away the lion's share in terms of value and volume of total out of home. So they are the most affected. But again, if you look at tier 2 markets or tier 3 markets, I would say the situation is much more better there as compared to tier 1 markets, which are the metro markets right now. So there is a lot of skepticism. You know, questions are getting asked and we are having debates with the clients. And that's how we are, you know, we are moving forward on the plans.
Mr. Mehta, you agree, you have something more to add?
Firstly, again, thank you for calling me here. And more than sharing any gyan with everybody, I'm taking this as an opportunity to learn from such an esteemed panel, because I think in this industry, I'm probably the youngest. At least as an entrant, that's what I mean. My view is very simple. Traditional media is dead, whether you're talking out of home or you're talking any other media. And I think COVID has just ensured, you know, that has happened in a faster, quicker manner. Any medium has to survive and thrive in this kind of environment has to be completely result-oriented. And how do you make it result-oriented is by being completely data-enabled, data-driven, technology-enabled, and digitally charged. If today you do not know what your ROI is, I don't think any advertiser will put in any money. Forget about the kind of monies they used to in the past on on any medium. So while Vinku spoke about mobility data and stuff like that, that is really the base on which this medium has got to come back. We have to change the way we functioned in the past. What has brought us here will not take us into the future. And which really means the entire ecosystem, whether it is technology providers such as Edgewan, who's on this panel, or it is the digital out-of-home media owners like Gautam is here, or it is agencies such as our competitors and us, we all need to reinvent this business. Of course, clients are coming back. I mean, as compared to April, May, obviously the business is improved, but April, May was zero. So, even one is infinitely more than zero. But if we have to claw back and gain our rightful place in the system and become a growth medium rather than just defending what we have, we need to completely revolutionize from top to bottom the way this medium is bought, sold, traded, and evaluated.
We will at least want to dedicate 5 minutes to, what kind of innovations and revolutions are required for the medium going forward. But to begin with, I want to bring in Pramod sir into the debate and ask him what, according to you, is the situation right now and is the right approach to go to a brand?
Thanks, Nazia. Thank you very much for having me on the panel. I really agree with Ajay. It is not going to be the same as it was. Post-COVID, we need to innovate. We have to have a different approach and different tools to really sell our medium. Having said it's very easy, but I think the way the industry has been really conducting their business in the past, and overnight, it's not going to happen really. While he was touching this for digital advertising, it's very minuscule in this country. It's in compared to the world data, it's hardly 3.5 or 4%. I mean, still to go a long way to really to establish its presence across. So it's a major issue really there for the DOH. We know that things will change. We all know that. How they will change still remains a mystery, really, because we all have gone through such a situation which nobody, all of us, has never heard, never seen. Heard, of course, we have heard about 1918 or something, but we had no idea about really, and nobody had talked about over a period. So it is a challenge. It is going to be a challenge. My feel is if all the stakeholders, they can get together, have a brainstorming, find out new tools to really approach advertisers, they are ready. They will come back. All of them, they will come back. Sometimes people say, some of the categories will vanish and new categories are going to emerge. No, I'm pretty sure that everybody is going to come back. And I have so much of faith in this medium. This medium will be the faster than any medium. It will come faster, undoubtedly. But yes, we all have, all stakeholders have to get together, have a new approach, different approach with different tools. We need to really, really think towards that to really bring them back. Advertisers are ready, as rightly Vinku said, some of them are starting coming back. More are waiting, just they're waiting really, that one category goes and the other will follow really, So I think it is our responsibility as an industry. We all are stakeholders, major stakeholders. Agencies are major, more than 50% of business is being handled by them. So we have to have a hand-holding really for that to go back to the clients, bring their confidence and start working and going forward on it.
Thank you, sir. Gautam and Mr. Singh, if I can bring you into the debate, digital solutions or technology, innovations, can you suggest to your partners here, which can help bring brands, help convince people like Mr. Bhutalia to get back to advertising aggressively on your medium? Gautam, if you can start.
So, you know, being a digital first organization, we've always invested heavily into our technology infrastructure. And to an extent, we're reaping some benefits from there today. In last 2 months, we've been able to create our in-house tool. It's called People. We will unveil it, I think, on Wednesday. And, you know, we've been able to very importantly quantify the number of people walking in into work, because at this point of time, my network BizTalk is live. So we've been able to quantify, classify, which again is very important. And the third aspect to it is we've created a platform through which we get mobile IDs, which gives an opportunity for brands to retarget them, either programmatically through an exchange or we do it for them. You know, this at least has started helping us track the, you know, ROI, which is very important today. Looking back at numbers, what used to be back in the day, the footfalls today, you know, they're going up by 7-8% week on week basis. And we've been able to do about between 22 to 28% footfalls across corporate hubs and co-working spaces. So it is only improving as public transport is available. And, you know, brands are very curious. It is very interesting in last 2 months, the kind of conversation. It's been 12 years for me in the out-of-home industry. And the kind of conversations we are having are completely different. Both briefs and our pitch have changed in last 2 months. Everything is purely data-driven. Earlier, I think, being an out-of-home professional, we used to talk about size of the display. Hey, this looks good. Today, the conversation has moved to, hey, how many people? And who are they? How am I reaching? Is the media relevant? Am I connecting? If I'm connecting, can I measure impact? There are so many questions we had to invest and come up with this tool. And now we've been able to get some traction moving forward.
Mr. Singh, before I get you into the debate, I just need to make one quick announcement that we're already live on Facebook, LinkedIn, Insta. And please feel free to send questions for the panelists, which I can take up post 4:30 when I'm done with my questions. So please keep sending your questions. So Mr. Singh, so what kind of technology solutions you think can help the domain?
Nadia, again, thank you to have me as in give me a platform with these dignitaries. The way we look at this entire scenario, this we actually look at the entire industry, being a service provider to IT partners, to media agencies, as well as maximum media owners, the all major big media owners in India, so and even overseas. So what we look at is the technology means the entire industry has to evolve. All big players, the way Gautam has told, they've got a new product developed where they're measuring. So things are, those parameters are same. Means the sentiment, the brand has to have a sentiment that yes, he is getting deliveries. He's whatever investment he's making, he is visible to people.
Some disruption.
Actually, it is. So different people are actually doing different kind of working. Measurement is something very crucial things. Data is something which is very important part of the entire thing. But yes, we need to look at the entire industry perspective. And we, in this kind of scenario, what I believe is that we need to do some kind of initiative. We need to take some kind of initiatives which are actually going to support the industry. If industry is there, me running alone won't be making that kind of benefit. So coming back to the point of technology, yes, we have done an initiative just very recently, and we are actually we've thought in the last 3-4 months that yes, we should give industry some kind of technology which should be a say non-commercial initiative from our side, where anyone and everyone in the industry, like from a small player to a bigger player, and we've been launching that kind of thing on the measurement thing again. So that measurement will be on your static locations, that measurement will be on digital deliveries. So that kind of holistic tool, which will be accessible, available to all. Means even small media owner working in tier 2, tier 3 city will be able to access it. There won't be any, you can say, very minimal kind of cost coming to him. But yes, he'll be able to take the benefit of the technology. So what all big players are today able to afford, but there is a very big quantum in our tier 2, tier 3 cities. There are a lot of media players. There are a lot of brands. There are small time players. So big players can definitely afford all the things. But we are trying to, you know, give something from our side to industry, where we are trying to give some technology push to those players which are actually not able to, you know, perform on a larger perspective. So we've recently come with a platform. We are going to very soon. We are going to, you know, dedicate it to the industry as such. So that platform will be more focusing on the measurement kind of thing, and it will be a non-commercial platform. I'm again rephrasing, coming back again to that thing. So that won't be commercial platform. There won't be no exploitation of the data which is getting collected. So that kind of data will be, means we can even link it to the industry bodies, associations and all. So that's how we look at it. So technologies, yes, as an industry, as an outdoor industry, the most important thing is delivery. The sentiment which a brand has to have is, yes, whatever he's investing, what ROI is coming back to him, how he can retarget that kind of audience, how he can reach to the correct audience, reach to the correct people. So today, you don't have to sell a location. I 100% agree to Gautam, to Ajay, Venku, that yes, we don't need to sell a site. We need to sell people. We need to sell audience. So that is the key mantra which we need to do today. And in this 3 to 4 months of lockdown, we've experienced, we were not free even for a single day. even we were having two times pressure on us the way we normally had. So most of the companies actually, they started cementing their backbones, their systems, their business processes, how quickly they can share a proposal, how quickly that proposal can have more and more data related to audience, related to demographics, related to gender. So that kind of integrations with their inventory, their locations. So those kind of best practices. And we have worked a lot with many customers who have actually tried to get more and more processes into the system. Means rather than have their businesses people driven, they are now having them process driven. So those kind of changes have come. That's what we've experienced.
Understood. Siddharth, if I can have you now in the debate, everyone, all the agency heads, people from technology front, they have told you, you know, how you can get back to outdoor. What is on your mind, and you know, how much do you feel convinced now? As a marketer, you know, somebody who has been doing a lot of advertisement on outdoor, particularly in Bangalore, what is the way forward as per you?
So first of all, thanks for having me. And honestly, it's very encouraging to hear some of the things which I've heard so far. As a marketer across the board, and I know especially for my team, one of the things that we look forward to is media planning and taking campaigns live. And that has taken a massive hit in this period. So to keep the excitement going and to take campaigns live, to reach out to consumers in the best manner possible is something that everyone looks forward to. We have traditionally spent actually more than 50% of our advertising budgets in the outdoor media. And we've always been asking some of the questions, for example, Gautam said, or Mr. Singh was talking about, in terms of who are the audiences who we need to talk to? How many impressions, etc. I think that's something which has always been top of mind for advertisers like us. But it's never had the same credence or importance because the industry didn't feel the need to reinvent itself. And that's why a lot of spends traditionally have moved on to digital formats. Even today, if you look at it, there is a lot more comfort for us spending on digital than it is on traditional media because we don't know who the audiences are and how relevant they are. I must say that I can completely empathize with a lot of what you're saying, because apart from running an airline, a large part of what we also do is, from an ancillary revenue perspective, sell media on our own sites. That includes our in-flight magazines, that includes our menus, but it also includes probably one of the largest and most innovative outdoor formats, which is the aircraft livery itself. So we were in discussions with clients before the lockdown happened. And it's the same questions which we are getting asked. How many people are actually flying? How do you ensure that those people will be flying? How many people will get to see it? Are they the same kinds of people who were flying earlier? all of those. One thing certainly which I think is going to have a massive impact, and which is encouraging for us, is that the nature of the media, the lack of clutter that there is in the market, affords an opportunity for those that are able to take the first step forward to actually get a lot more visibility. And that's the same which is true for digital media as well. The cost of spends on digital media, including the likes of publishers like Google, is significantly lower today than it was earlier because there is a lack of other advertisers. So there is a first mover advantage to be taken. And brands that are bold enough to take that, I think will definitely get the advantage of that. The second is that the reinvention certainly needs to be there. Digital will lead the way forward for that. We've seen that happening in the aviation industry itself with travel and technology. So those players who are able to deploy technology faster will not just make their pitches more appealing, but will actually have a long-term impact on shifting spends from other categories onto out of home, which has long been something that should have done. So that's something that I think is certainly moving in the right direction. I think what will happen is that the trends which would have taken 2 or 3 years to have come upon will get accelerated as an opportunity in this case. That crisis would have converted into an opportunity. So as advertisers, I think we certainly look forward to that. And it's very encouraging to hear some of the things that I've heard today, honestly.
You've not given a definitive answer. How soon are you going back?
We'd like to go back as soon as possible. So very honestly, we have not gone back with any other form of advertising so far, whether it be on print.
Except digital.
We've done digital. We have done a bit of television with LVAD recently on technical campaigns. I think one of the struggles that we have with outdoor and what will probably help us is that with the nature of uncertainty that there is currently in the market, the dynamism that there is in terms of even what we should be communicating, which route should we be advertising, will there be travel to certain destinations, what are the state restrictions going to be, the same kind of things. So one of the struggles is that with outdoor, it's a large format which you typically put up. Our investment has traditionally also been quite a lot in airport media or in certain cities like Kolkata, where there is digital media available in outdoor spaces. Because the flexibility and the adaptability to change the communication of the campaign is something that will play an even greater weight for us now. So as long as there are media that we can change quickly, as long as there are media that afford the same kind of reach, I think with a cost perspective, certainly outdoor is one of the most effective. And so, I mean, I certainly see us coming back into that space with larger investments to the tune of what we had earlier, sooner rather than later. With a definitive timeline, honestly, I don't know at the moment.
Also, because yours is one of the sectors which has also been as badly impacted as the outdoor in media domain. So, I have already got lots of questions from audiences. So, I want to ask some of my questions as quickly as possible. And we'll try to keep the answers crisp because we're almost like 6-7 people on the panel. Pramod, sir, I want to bring you back into the discussion. There have been two recent High Court judgments. One was about with regards to, you know, taking down COVID mandated ads. So will that, now that you have your space back, will that lead to growth? I mean, how is it going to help you in the coming weeks or days?
Can you repeat your question, please? This is regarding High Court judgment in Bombay.
Yeah, the Bombay High Court recently gave a verdict with regards to taking down COVID mandated ads. So, will the growth of campaigns from your clients see a spike now? The government mandated COVID ads were displayed for a period of 3 months, which caused a grave financial constraint. Should there be a compensation package for all out-of-home owners for this? So, I have these two questions.
See, lawfully, it's a force majeure situation which is prevailing today. It's an act of God. So, each concession which we signed with the authorities have this kind of provision or an article already in. So we, almost everyone, media owner, have gone back to the authorities, to their principals, revoking that particular article and asking for the relief. I don't foresee any problem in that. It might take some time because the government and the bureaucrats, they don't have any idea, neither we have an idea. Nothing has happened this kind of situation well before in the near past. It is going to be a bit tough fight, but it's a clear written on the wall, like, yes, we are going to fight back and to get some relief. One. Two, when you're talking about Bombay particularly as a market, like, yes, government had initiated to put all billboards, to pull down all the commercial ads and to put COVID-related messages. And appropriately, they waived off the license fee for that particular time. So that's a part. But yes, as a industry, we are going to fight back, and we are already fighting. But it's going to be a tough fight and a long fight with the government. It's not easy just around, like, you know, that we are going to get any relief quickly or in a weeks. No.
Okay. Vinku, would you want to answer the first part of the question that I asked, that now that the space is available to you, will it see some kind of spike in, you know, clients coming back to you and asking for that space?
Nazia, right now we are facing a problem in terms of metro cities, what I mentioned earlier, in terms of, if you look at the total numbers, total impressions which are getting generated. We can measure the impressions that we see in different markets. So we see that the impressions in metro markets today are not equivalent to what used to be pre-COVID era. You know, the bounce back is much more better in tier 2 and tier 3 markets. So one, I would say, to some extent, yes, in the last 2 months, we have seen higher traction of traffic movement. I'm talking about traditional media right now. But again, it is not what it was earlier. So I think that gap needs to be filled up. And we have seen in the last couple of days restrictions coming up in different markets, be it Mumbai market or Bangalore or Chennai for that matter. So markets are affected right now, especially the metro markets currently. Even in terms of corporate spaces, you know, wherein we have a lot of digital, the numbers are impacted right now, even in metro cities. So earlier, if we were...
There's been absolutely, yeah, like, if in terms of percentages, I asked you, How much has it been better than April, May?
Can I answer this question? Vinku, sure. Because sure, I have a data for 4 cities, which is the latest, and it's by the Apple Mobility, and the data was generated on 2nd of July for 4 cities only in India, but it's in the rest part of the world they have already given. The first is Bangalore, which is the traffic I'm talking about. It's minus 44%. Chennai, it's minus 76%. Delhi, 49%, minus 49%. Mumbai, minus 67%.
So, Nazia, you have seen the numbers, what Ramoji just talked about right now.
You guys really have a very tough job
now. It's tough. I mean, that's what I said. Like, you know, it's a mystery. It's going to take some time. It's not so easy. Like, you know, we can talk, really, you know. Even initially, I was of opinion, no, it's going to be June end and we are going to come back fast. But as we all see, like, you know, it's tough, difficult times.
Ajay, if you can join us back in the debate, what I would want to understand, we all now, I mean, Pramod sir has given us numbers which clearly show that the situation out there is really grim. What kind of innovations do you suggest the industry should do? Do we need to come up with new touch points? Should we, because people aren't traveling, should we move out of airports to, you know, residential areas? What is that new skill set that outdoor agencies need to adapt in the post-lockdown environment?
Very interesting question, because you have to follow what the consumer is doing, right? And if you look at April and May, we were all completely at home. Hardly anybody stepped out. But now what you're seeing, in spite of the numbers, you know, which Pramodji gave out, people have at least started coming out of their homes. They may be just going to the local market, to the local supermarket, or just going on. Like, I went on a drive last night, just, you know, within my neighborhood, just about 2 kilometers. So people have started getting out of their homes. The touch points can be created or activated around residential areas, for one, right? What you can call hyper-local. So as you get out, as you are going, stepping out of your apartment or your flat, you may not be going to the Juhu Beach or to India Gate, but you have definitely started stepping out. That's one. Two, as we are seeing offices reopen, most of your out-of-home activity is going to be going to your office and coming back. Yes. So while, of course, there are considerations of 20%, 40%, 30%, whatever is the office capacity. But you're seeing a whole lot of SMEs already back in action, right? They can't afford to shut their home. So your out of home journeys are really going to be only to office and back. And slowly it will keep improving. So that's the second thing. Third thing, if you look and divide all out of home really into two things, either routes or destinations, right? Some of the destinations, the malls, for example, or cinemas, for example, those will probably take a longer time to come back. But routes are definitely going to be, are already seeing some sort of traffic. And while we are 60%, 40%, 50% down, the important thing is that number is improving day on day, week on week. So we may or may not come back to 100 in a month or 2 months or even longer, but you will come back to, and which probably is a good thing, our roads will be better, our traffic will be lesser. But from the perspective whether they will reach a sizable mass, I just think it's going to come back very quickly. So routes and destination, focus on routes and focus on hyperlocal, whether it is near residential. And to your specific question of airports, I think what is interesting, and I was looking at some data, already if you look at Delhi Airport, and of course Siddharth is much better equipped to answer that, but I think Delhi already the sheer number of flights seems to be increasing quite rapidly. I'm not sure of how many people per flight, but at least in terms of sheer number of flights, a lot of holidays have been postponed, a whole lot of leisure travel has been pushed back. But man by nature is a social being. As and when a certain amount of assurance comes that it's okay to travel, I see a huge amount of pent-up demand coming up. I mean, I can tell you, my two daughters every third day are asking me, so we didn't go on a summer holiday. I hope we are going to go during the Dussehra break. I see a whole lot of pent-up demand. And airports are in a unique position to deliver premium audiences in an environment where they have time. That cannot be replaced overnight. That's just an extremely unique touch point, which is going through an immediate challenge that will come out of it.
Pramod, sir, would you want to add to that? What kind of, do we need to change the touch points? What kind of innovations do we need to bring in?
See, it's a good question. That's what I started with my brief, which was that agencies, they are the major stakeholders, media owners, of course. We need to really, if we can, I mean, it's a very crazy idea I have in mind. If sentiments are low, the numbers I have given, yes, they are increasing. They will increase in the coming months, of course. Yeah, but in spite today, almost we have 50% traffic on the roads in Delhi, but there is no campaign. Hardly a couple of them, few of them, maybe one or two, which Vinku was talking about. And that too, and we have been pushing for since 3rd May onwards when the lockdown was uplifted. My point is that it has to be something. We cannot have the same tools what we have been doing really in the past. We have to go back to the clients together to show, to tell, to give the data and to bring their confidence to tell them, yes, the audience is there on the road. Ajay was right, he said that less number of traffic, but this outdoor can be perfectly great, with less number of people, because you are at leisure in driving, right? You have a more visibility and you have better you can see the outdoor.
So you also think that we need to have new touch points. I mean, we need to go hyper local.
We need to innovate something really, which can bring the confidence back of the advertisers. And the first, it could be really, we as a media owner also can really start with the local retailers, local retail and brands. Really bring them back, so that it's very important. If one category is there on the outdoor, the same category the people they follow. This has to be a new start. It has to be a new start. let's look at that.
Would you have any kind of suggestion in your head, you know, things that you're planning to do? If you can give specific examples of, you know, what kind of innovations can we bring in?
Before I answer that question, Azhi, I would like to just say that, you know, our country is a huge country. You know, if there is a dip in the spends in metro markets today, let's not assume that there is a dip in the tier 2 and tier 3 markets as well. What we are currently witnessing is a very urban, very, very metro-specific phenomenon, which is in play because of multiple reasons. We know that these cities are the ones which are the most impacted by COVID right now. So that is one point. Second point, I agree with Ajay and with Pramodji also that, you know, we need to use more of hyper-local branding right now, because all the travel that we are doing is within the catchment areas of wherever we stay. So more within the hyper-local area, outside out-of-home, also there is a lot of out-of-home, I would say, medium, which can be built within neighborhoods.
Yeah. Which are, so have you actually started doing it?
What we are doing is that, you know, already in multiple cities, there are mediums which are available, both hyper-locally and also within the complexes itself. So we are proposing that to our clients, and hopefully we should get to use these mediums as well in the immediate future too.
Gautam, you want to add to it?
So I agree with all three, Ajay, Pramodji and Vinku. I think we can bridge that gap by understanding both you know, how consumers' lifestyle has changed. One, what is the brand sentiment and what is the solution? So as far as agency pitch is concerned, I'm sure Ajay and Vinku know best. But whatever has helped us, I'd like to share. So whenever I'm talking to a client today, the first thing I start, you know, when I start fresh, I say, let's start from zero. Let's not think about what used to be there. Let's talk today. So let's say, you know, we have media in about 6 cities, in corporate parks, salmon bars, restaurants, which are obviously shut, gaming destination. So even if you look at, let's say, 25 to 30% of old numbers today across India, reaching 2.5 lakh people in a captive environment is, you know, is a very good proposition for a brand. Now, as media owners and agency, why can't we propose, you know, commercials that complement the size of the audience? That is something that needs to, you know, come in OOH. Earlier, out of home was always sold on, let's say, size of the media or location, on pure gut feeling. Today, so we have been able to sell media. I think we are starting campaigns this week, and you'll obviously come to know. And these are, you know, good budget campaigns that we've been able to convert. Everything is data driven. If there is 30% audience out there, my price is quoted accordingly. Plus, we are tracking, measuring.
That's what you mentioned in your previous thing also, that now we need to not go by size of the hoarding, but size of the people, you know, where...
Just size of the people.
In fact, one of our viewers has given a very good solution. And I mean, these were the kind of solutions I think I'm keen for from each one of you to share, that he's saying, why don't we use elevators? You know, for because I mean, irrespective of what, people are still using elevators, they're going up and down to do whatever their local movement. So the elevator companies are coming with the digital outdoor solutions for the elevators. You can advertise on the elevator doors, elevator walls, etc. digitally. How successful do you think these solutions will be? Mr. Singh, you want to talk about it?
Yes, sure. So these solutions will be actually very effective. Means
if we can have now, more such solutions, you know, yeah. This is such an
it's an innovative idea, and things are already moving. That there are already players who are offering this elevator ads spaces and all. There are already people who are doing it. So yeah. The way I look at it, like when we have to go to brands, we need to go them with a solution. Not just with the service, the way Gautam has said that earlier things were being sold by the size of the location. Now it has to actually, we need to do some homework. We need to be more prepared, more data driven, and we have to go to the brand telling him that, yes, this will be the impact. What all you are going to invest, we do need to have some kind of working on making some kind of impact reports where we are going to them with, yes, this is the audience, this could be the impact, this will be the investment, and this is how it will get converted. So it will be a very brand centric kind of approach we need to take from now. So to each individual branch, brand, agencies, media owners, now they have to do a lot of homework while going to them, and they have to give them a solution, just not a kind of space that, yes, this is what, where you can come and do your branding. So that's what I feel. And the idea of elevators, that is something which is something like whatever happens, that will always be there. So that is something very beautiful media format which can be used, and all media agencies should think over that.
We have 20 minutes left and we have already got some 20 questions. I'll now start asking questions which have been directed to particular people. So I'll take this up for Siddharth. Why have few of Air Asia campaigns went down from went down from domestic airports post COVID? As you mentioned, the first movers will have advantage. When do you think of restoring your airport campaigns quickly with respect to domestic route promotions, provided you get good digital media presence there?
So, excellent question. I mean, to answer the first part, why did they go down? They went down because we were not flying and nobody was. So, airport media didn't make sense for us to have. And because of the same reason, a lot of the arterial routes that we'd taken, for example, coming in from the airport into Bangalore City, we had acquired over a long period of time, quite a few years, in fact, something which we were very proud of, which is we'd taken a string of about 20 odd boardings. As we grew our destinations, we sort of grew that number of outdoors in a string out to about 30 or so, coming to where the toll booth was. Now, it's important to understand the way in which some of these media plans happen and what the logic of these are. One of the reasons why we take a toll booth campaign, for example, or we took 30 hoardings over there, is because there is a long waiting time at the toll booths, right? So I'm willing to pay a premium for that because I know that people are sitting over there with nothing else to do. And I know that there is a lot of traffic coming in from there. Now, in the current scenario, I know how many people are actually coming from the airport. The nature of that demand is moving from the non-discretionary travel slowly to a more discretionary travel. And so as soon as that discretionary travel audience comes up, it makes sense for us, obviously, to advertise again over there. But some of these other factors, waiting times at these locations, will play against another location, for example. Now, what we had taken earlier, for instance, a lot was bus shelters. We were cognizant of the fact, coming into the same city in Bangalore, that we had a lot of traffic which was organized towards these spaces. Now, we were also in touch with organizations like car rental companies, right, to see whether we take out of our media in those spaces. Those no longer make sense. However, at the same time, it makes a lot more sense for us if you look at, and we were similar to the statistics which were shared, there is reports which are published by Google, which are actually for healthcare. They're the COVID-19 mobility reports. It tracks your Google Maps data and tells you how much sector by sector people are going up or down, right? If you look at retail and recreation versus the baseline, which was there earlier, around May, there was an 85% drop. That is now only a 60% drop, right? Supermarkets and pharmacies are only 5% down to where the baselines were, but they're hyper-local markets like where they are now. So it makes sense to advertise in those destinations, right? Public transport, which was down about 65%, is now down about 39%. Now, what is happening in our minds is a lot more people are not taking shared or car rental services and are driving themselves, or are not taking public transport but are self-driving. That means the audience that I want to reach is actually looking out of the window a lot more. People are a lot more aware of where they're going. When you speak of elevators or you speak of public places, supermarkets, malls, etc., wherever people are going, they're no longer sitting and watching their phones. So telephone advertising is actually losing to out-of-home media because people are looking around a lot more and seeing where there is. So honestly, for us, we are trying to reimagine the way in which we're looking at how media is consumed, and we haven't fully wrapped our heads around that. Airport media will always be something that we're very keen on. And that's something that, if you look at the government, the mandate has been so far that every airline on a sector operates only till about 33% or one third of their capacity. That is now increased to 45%. As that ramps up and those capacities increase, the number of travelers increase. I just spoke about Delhi Airport, for example, right? It obviously makes sense for us to be in those media because those are relevant audiences.
It's been a good rate of growth. Mm-hmm. No? If it has already reached 45% in...
45% is honestly the capacity which you can operate at from where you are.
Okay.
Not everybody.
So you're already running full in a way, no?
So you're not running full when you are...
If 45% is your cutoff and you're getting 45%, is that what you said?
So 45% is the cutoff for how much you can operate as an aircraft. For example, if you are operating, say, 100 routes on Bombay-Delhi, now you can operate 45 routes on Bombay-Delhi, right?
Okay.
So the traffic itself, the max capacity is down to about, or will be down to 45%, was currently 33%. The loads are also slightly lower, where you were getting 85%, 84% loads, those would be down to about 60%, right? So cumulatively, you're down to about a quarter in terms of the traffic of what it was earlier, which is slowly ramping up and will reach, I think, about 40% odd, right? So from that perspective, any media that affords me an opportunity of a cost reduction of a similar number, say of a 60% cost reduction, makes sense to advertising. And those media are becoming increasingly available now, right? And as I said, the clutter, the fact that the people who are traveling are more resilient. For example, you'll see younger audiences traveling, right? You'll see people being more aware of their surroundings and looking out for communication. It's more experimental audiences by the nature of the people who are traveling. So those are individuals who you would want to reach out to much more than the wastage, which was there earlier, is a lot less now. So those opportunities, honestly, are there now. And it's just a matter of brands like us. And I said the first mover advantage will go to those who act first. Being able to engage with you know, sellers, with partners who are selling those media. Being able to convince internal stakeholders as well. Because with all of these organizations, you must recall, while marketeers are fairly keen, given the financial pressures that there are discussions to be had with our respective CFOs, other stakeholders internally, board members, to say, look, it makes sense to advertise now. And some of the data points that we talked about today actually will help as those proof points to be able to do that. So I see that coming back certainly with the likes of digital media, with the likes of digital out-of-home media, and airports coming back a lot quicker. And we are quite keen to take ownership again of the media that we have let go, because we're cognizant of the fact that it took us many years to build up those media assets. So yeah, we're quite keen to have those back, and we will be planning to do that. I don't want to share too much of that because it's competitive strategy that one would give away. But it's
fair enough. We actually are flooded with questions and I have very little time left. I'm scared I might have to take 5-10 minutes more of your time, because at least I should take up some questions from the audiences. I also request, now I have a question for all the agency heads. If you can give me crisp answers in like maybe 2 sentences or 3 sentences. This is for Viku, Ajay and Pramod sir. Everyone is apprehensive about coming back to advertise right now. Who will take the lead and which categories will follow? So if you can, Pramod sir, if I can start with you, which are the categories you think will quickly now, hopefully, will start advertising on outdoor, considering that we have festive season coming from August, or, you know, it usually starts from August. So what are the categories you are hopeful will start coming back to you soon?
See, one is the local retailers. I feel like, you know, they if really the right approach we all have with them, they'll come back. Of course, I'm looking at OTT is doing pretty very well, no doubt about it. They have done a lot well before before COVID also, they were doing very well, and now of course during COVID they have done a wonderful job. And they must be loaded with a lot of money. And if it has a right approach by media owners and agencies, I think agencies play a vital role in getting that particular segment on board. That will be a great contribution to the OH. FMCG, I feel like, should be more active. They should be more active. And so as automobile, I feel like, you know, the two-wheelers and the automobile will do great job. If a right strategy, again, saying that, like, you know, agencies have to play a vital role in it, really, you know, because they are the face to that. HRD.
Vinku, you think you agree or you have some new categories to add?
I agree with Pramodji and I will add on to his list. I also think that mobile handsets will be advertising more. BFSI category would be advertising more, along with consumer durables and e-commerce in the coming months, because entire festive season is there. Though we had 3 months of no campaigns, but we will definitely have 5 to 6 months of more campaigns happening now.
Ajay?
They pretty much covered all the categories, but I just want to add something to what Siddharth said, and I think that's a very interesting point. He spoke about the fact that there are various stakeholders in an organization, and you know, as agencies or as media owners, we have to make sure that we help our clients, you know, people such as Siddharth, convince the other stakeholders to come back. And that for me is the key, because it's not just about people coming back on roads. Advertising budgets are going to be looked at far more closely. And whether it is something as basic as Google mobility data or building profiles, which I think Gautam touched upon in terms of audience profiling, if we can convince our clients that there is return on investment with their OOH investments, all categories can come back. If we don't do that, you don't have any birthright to even one penny of the advertiser's budget.
Gautam, there's a quick question for you. Please try to answer it as crisply as you can. In India, which is a very price-sensitive market, post-COVID commercial places are not sure if they will have the same traction of footfall in their premises. How do you see the prices for digital advertising face an impact?
Well, I think I just spoke about this
But he's talking about prices now.
So that's what I said. So the way we've been selling, so we start from zero. We, you know, let's forget whatever the budgets were earlier, placed into commercial complexes. So even if it is a, let's say, between 20 to 30% of what it was back in the day, our the money that we are quoting complements the audience that is present there. So clients actually do not have, you know, any problems. They do not hesitate. Also, you know, Kinetic, as an agency, Kinetic joined hands with Zach, says the entire transition was happening, I think, pre-COVID. We were able to do a lot of business with Zach, says. So, you know, entire out-of-home, which was very vanilla branding, today is ROI-driven. So, being a digital platform, the cost is flexible. We sell impressions. And, you know, can optimize a campaign as per budget.
Pramod sir, there's a question for you. Thanks, Gautam. Pramod sir, there's a question for you about... I just lost the question.
Yeah, there are too many.
It was about the High Court order that if we renegotiate... would renegotiation on taxes by government and rate revision help to get more clients on board?
Really, the industry is suffering, really, you know, because there is no business, and your license and your minimum guarantee, which generally you commit with the government or with your principal, is to be paid back to them. If whatever relief the industry get, that will be a solace and will be good for them to sustain. Otherwise, it's going to be tough for some of the media owners.
So this question, any one of you can take. Since COVID-19 outbreak is there and out-of-home media owners have been losing business too, will it be justifiable if agencies are asking for discounts from media owners? Clients like OTT platforms, which are doing so much better, are asking for huge discounts. So does this make sense? Is what somebody who's named himself Anonymous has asked.
Can I answer this
question? Yeah, please, sir.
I would request agencies to please support media owners, because we coexist, right? And as I said, that almost 50% of the total business is being handled by agencies. So my appeal and request to agencies is that they should support at this time and release entire money which is for the campaigns which has already been done. And they have got the money. So this way, we will be helping the media owners to really sustain and to come back in a positive manner, really. So this is very important for agencies to really not to ask for any discount.
Yes.
So measurement has always been an issue with your domain. This gentleman called Mr. Ravi Ambrose, he wants to ask, wouldn't it be better that media owners and agencies come out with a monthly traffic count report, as that would help build confidence among brand owners. Ajay, you want to answer that?
I'll take that. So I think definitely that is one idea, but there's a whole lot of stuff which as an industry needs to happen, right? I think there was an article in Exchange for Media only recently about one common measurement system, which is absolutely necessary. I mean, you can't have pockets of, you know, of Gotham trying to do something and someone else trying to do something.
One common, if I can intervene, Ajay, I've been in this industry for 3.5 years and every 4 months we do that article, but I've not seen that industry come up.
So that is something which
I can only report. It's for all of you to put that.
Absolutely, and very rightfully so. And you know, till the time you do not come with a currency and which covers everything, whether it is measurement, whether it is monitoring, whether it is in terms of, you know, CPM measures, etc.
Where is it stuck? You know, I
honestly wouldn't know that. I mean, I've just come into this industry.
And now that you're in a crisis, now that you're in a crisis, is it even not more important for you guys to have a measurement system?
I definitely think people like Vinku or Pramodji and, you know, who are leaders in this space, thought leaders, agencies such as ours, need to come together and have a dialogue on this. And absolutely, any crisis is an opportunity, and this is the time. So to answer the gentleman's question, yes, there is absolutely a need for all of that. And I think the industry will be doing itself a big disservice if it lets its personal aspirations or egos come in the way of an industry-specific system.
Upendraji, I think you wanted to make a point. I'm sorry.
I wanted to make a point on this. So what Ajay is saying now, or Pramodji has said now, that is something which I said in my introductory discussion, that yes, we need to coexist. So we today being serving more than 100 media owners pan India of all scales, we took this initiative 3-4 months back. And we, as I've already told you, that yes, we are. Means when you make some measurement tool, or everyone is making, means every agency is having some measurement tool or some data tool or something. And when they go to the brands, they means different numbers are actually coming. So what we are trying to do, we are coming up with a non-commercial, again, I'm repeating it, non-commercial and a very, very that kind of platform where no data will be used for any kind of commercial activity, which we are trying to, because we are having more than 100 media owners for whom we are already serving. And they are differently using different applications for measurement and all other things. And we are actually trying to do it for last 3-4 months, that we are coming up with a platform which could be a common platform bridging all of them. When you look at the measurement or different kind of demographics of locations, because already those companies are using our tools. They are automating their business processes on H1. So it's been easy for us because we have already working with them for a long time now. So it's very easy for us to, you know, just make them, to convince them to have their data on one platform. And we being just a technology player, not having any kind of interest in media selling or that kind of arena. So I believe we are trying to make that kind of platform for the industry. And
No, I mean, I'm just saying, whether it is Mr. Singh or someone else, there is a need for the industry to come together and have a common direction in which it's going. Now, whether it is in terms of using technology platforms provided by third-party players or something else, that is something to be debated and discussed. Is there a need for common measurement system? Without an iota of a doubt, yes.
Also, you're a veteran. If you can just tell us where exactly is it stuck? Because, you know, even in March when we did that event, I remember there were conversations that, you know, in maybe another 15, 20 days or another 1 month, we'll have it. And now where, I mean, apart from COVID, where else is it stuck?
Good point. It's a very relevant concern of the industry, of advertisers, of media owners, everybody, because We cannot grow until unless you have currency. IOAA, I'm also part of that, one of the member there, can share a bit, little bit, like, you know, what we have been pursuing. We have been working very seriously along with AAAIs of Advertising Agencies of India Association, very closely. And finally, we have reached to a consensus where we are in a process of working on an RFP, which we are working. Due to this COVID, it has been derailed a bit. But we are working on an RFP, which will be floated very soon, maybe within this year.
Very soon, has to have a date.
A date, I can't give you a date because the board haven't met together for the last 3-4 months. So I think I'll be able to give a precise answer in a couple of weeks. But yes, for sure, Ajay, I can guarantee you as a media owner, as an industry body, yes, we are seriously working on it.
Pramojit, Abhi, let's have a chat offline and let's work on this. I have to step out. I have something else, but it's been
It's 5 o'clock. We are closing it only. I actually wanted to end it on festive season's predictions because that's one happy, positive time that we look forward to. Not just for business, even personally. And we're hoping that things will start to settle by then. People will fly more. Would you want to just, Ajay, if you have to move out, you can. But because
I'll just say one thing and I'll...
So you can start your closing remarks on, what are your expectations from festive season, and then we're going to close it any which ways.
So as they say, the king is dead, long live the king. Right? The out-of-home industry, the way we knew it, is dead. There is a new industry which has to be born. Everybody needs to change. If we change, why festive we can even do well in this time? If we don't, even festive can't save us. That's my view.
Great, Ajay. Binko? Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ajay. Thanks for joining us. Thanks. Binko, your final remarks.
Yeah. So, Nazia, there are a couple of launches which could not happen in the previous quarter. So those launches across categories will definitely happen in the coming months right now. And India advertising has been skewed towards festive. So if you even pick up any year, which has been a normal year, there's a big skew, not only of out-of-home, but all out-of-home mediums towards festive. So definitely we see a higher uptake of all mediums, specifically out-of-home, also in the coming months. And advertising would be across categories. It will not be one category specifically, but multiple categories, multiple players who would be advertising in markets.
Gautam?
If you're able to close business at this point of time, I'll consider it as festive season. It's been pretty bad out there. And with the whole festive season, we keep, making ourselves happy. And I'd like to stick to that and end on a positive note. But yeah, things are picking up. It's not that bad anymore. So if things stay well, it's going to be good for who has.
Any percentage that you're looking at, that maybe
20%? So we've been actually able to convert some business in last 2 weeks, which was not expected. Unfortunately, it did not come to me from out of home. It has come either directly or digital channels, which is another very big learning for OH, how to sell media in today's time. Need to quantify to qualify. So we are also learning. I think it's a new era for out of home, and we're all still in the learning stages.
Good luck. Mr. Singh, your closing remarks on festive season or whatever, anything that you want to
Every day is a festival actually. We are on right track. If we are target oriented, we have got all processes, proper ways, everything in line in a proper way, we can do means anything, means every day can convert. So it's just not a festive season. So I 100% agree to what Ajay have said, that we need to change. If we will change, we can do everything together.
Siddharth.
Thank you.
I tend to agree. I think, we've been mapping the sentiment from in three phases, that isolation phase, which was very fearful and anxious. It's moving towards a more cautious, kind of optimistic stage at this point of time, though still fairly unsure. For the festive season, starting off September, October, we're looking at something which is very exploratory, which is very celebratory, which also doesn't take for granted the things that we have so far, whether that is the freedom of movement, the freedom of travel, connecting with communities. So all of that will be a big play. I think if you're able to emotionally connect with individuals in that period, those that reinvent themselves will see a good sway. Those that don't, like Gautam said, will fall by the wayside because this is a revolutionary time. So it's opportunities for some and for those that sort of stay behind, yeah, it won't be. But
Pramod sir, will you close it for us?
Okay, thank you. I would say, Siddharth, thank you. Really, you validated that OOH just works, really, and it's been really pretty for Air Asia. And we know that all across Asia, you're doing phenomenally very well and doing great, some of the great outdoor, one can see, really. I do hope we will have better festive season than what is being experienced presently. I mean, it's as I said, that it's tough time, but we will be through soon. But of course, it cannot be compared with the previous years in this year. That's for sure. But yes, from here to the festive season, we'll have better days ahead. Definitely, we'll have better.
Thank you so much, each one of you, for joining us. We really hope
that you
believe we have already left the worst behind us, and going from here, we'll only have good news to share, and you'll all have good business to do, which will also give us good business in future. Thank you so much. At home, stay safe. Even if you have to fly, take care of yourself and to take all the precautions. Thank you, each
one. Even if you have to fly Air Asia.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. I can try.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.